So we're on the Skyliner to Epcot with Meg and Kate. Paul and Harry are having a rest day. I don't know what we're doing here. Harry's going on a Figment and we're in
the
passage. And then
we are now traveling along where we should drive.
That's Luke's plan for every day.
And the
little A-ride in the piece.
We're established in 1969 when Walt Disney World Resort was first being developed.
Okay. So we're at Epcot. Obviously Skyliner takes you in between the UK and France via the International Gateway, is that what it's called? Focus. I don't really know what the plan is. What is the plan?
We're going to do rides this morning and then you and Luke are going to come back this afternoon and
okay.
do our World Showcase.
So we're going to attempt to do as many rides as we can this morning and then Luke and I are coming back this evening to do World Showcase apparently. However, if my shoes get wet again, I will not be impressed. 2 days in a row, I have ended up wading through rivers because of the rain. I don't mind the rain. My mind is rivers.
You're in the UK.
I want to see Luke's impression of the UK pavilion. Because to me, it's like Tewkesbury.
She just said it's like Tewkesbury.
Or like little bits of Bath. $12.99 for fish and chips, Luke. Not including the tax. This is not what is normally here. No, there's normally the there's normally the football tops, man. Is more what I was. Morning. Oh, where have all the football tops gone? Are there no longer football tops?
Bro, they don't have the best chocolate ever.
No, but they have Milky Bars.
They don't have a double decker. That's the best chocolate.
Take your bet.
$5. What about the double decker?
Really?
Can't be a double decker.
I'm very confused what they've done with all the football shirts.
Or a boost.
They had loads of football shirts. And now they're gone.
I don't have the best chocolate
bar. He won't stop going on about this bloody double decker. Oh, are these the Cambridge Satchel Company, do you reckon? I like a satchel, but not that much.
I used to like a satchel. I like it. I have my choice, but that made me.
Right. To Soarin', maybe, or Figment.
This is one of our discoveries, the Figment of imagination.
Yeah, I know all about the senses. There's sight, sound, smell, touch, goochie goochie go, and taste. Taste like chicken. Can I go? Please, please, please.
No, I don't want you out of my sight.
Out of sight? Okay. Come on, everybody. Here we go.
Figment, you are not to interfere with the tour.
But you've got it wrong, Doc. It's not about listening with your ears. It's about listening with your imagination. Woo! You win one cent.
Pigment, don't!
Oh, yeah.
Really sticks.
Of course, Doc. Upside down, now you're talking. That's the best idea you've had all day. With just a spark of inspiration, I made my house an innovation. Imagination really wound around. Makes town tied up and upside down.
As you can plainly see, imagination works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc! Imagination is a blast!
Imagination.
Neverland. I'm trying to get it to focus, there you go.
Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests now and into the future.
Track up free.
The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions.
Jackfruit.
Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. One day, many of these lesser-known tropical plants may be as important as the bananas growing on both sides of the boat. More than 28 million tons of bananas are eaten annually, making it the most popular fruit in the world. Farming, you probably don't think of fish, but fish farming, or aquaculture, accounts for nearly half of all the seafood consumed globally. Tilapia, bass, and catfish, like the ones you see here, are three of the more popular crops raised by fish farmers. The sustainable system we're using here recycles the water in the tanks. As a result, we're able to save millions of gallons each year. Our small fish farm produces nearly 5,000 pounds of fish each year to serve in restaurants around Walt Disney World. Innovations like this one can play an important role in our efforts to produce bountiful harvests and still protect natural resources.
Shrimp. What the huge? Hidden mini.
While there are more than 50,000 edible plant species in the world, most of us are only familiar with the people that make up our everyday diet. The common grains growing here, wheat, maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world. These plants are definitely on their way up. Innovative growing techniques like these increase yields while more efficiently using resources like water, fertilizer, and pesticides. Another innovation at work here is our integrated pest management program. By populating our greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests, like aphids and flies, we are significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides. We're growing these crops using our nutrient film system. This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area. Some of our best ideas have been inspired by nature, like these fruit and vegetable trees. By growing these ground plants vertically, we can increase yields and better control diseases. These crops taste as good as they look. In fact, we serve more than 15 tons of produce from our greenhouses in restaurants here at the land every year. The future of agriculture may include innovative ideas like this vertical growing system. Plants grown in this way use a fraction of the space required by traditional growing methods. That saves water and increases production. The aquaponic system on your left combines hydroponics with aquaculture. The fish provide a natural source of fertilizer for the plants, and the plants help keep the water clean for the fish. It's another great way to produce more while using less. In our lab, Epcot scientists are working with the U.S. Department of Agriculture on a number of innovative projects. The goal of these efforts is to produce higher yielding and better quality plants.
No, I don't want you to hold the water, I want you to vlog. So we've just come out of the land, we've done soaring and living with the land. Soaring was only a 10-minute wait, which for 9:30 actually surprised me. But then I guess majority of people will have ran to Test Track and Gardens of the Galaxy. Lou, what did you think about soaring?
It's pretty boring.
You just don't like anything, do you?
No, I just, it's a one and done thing. I don't think you need to do it again.
Alright, and what about living with the land?
Well, it's very interesting.
Did you?
Yeah.
Okay. We're heading over, too close. We're heading over to Seas with Nemo and Friends now. We might do Turtle Talk with Crush, yeah, we might not. Luke would like to do it, but it depends on whether he fancies doing it today or not. Seems for Nemo and Fred says it's only 5 minutes, but the amount of people walking in here tells me no. So we'll see.
That's a pretty cool sign, but for $150, maybe not.
Especially since you don't even like Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah.
Great. How many people are leaving
here? Yeah. Another bath toy.
Oh no, it's one of
a
those.
A stress ball. Same as one from the spring. Yeah, but not. Guess we're already having that. Yeah. So this is $50 for Star-Lord's helmet.
Not awful, you can get Rocket's tail. Look at the little Gamora top. That's cute.
phone cases as well. Magnets for fridges.
Sorry, what's that?
Mini rubber and a razor maybe.
No, it's hard. What is it?
It's not a magnet.
Zandarian currency.
How boring. Badges that so you can put onto your jackets.
How much are they? $9.99.
More currency.
Villain bounty. It's a hella one.
And we'll go over to the Star Wars. So you got Mandalorians.
What is it?
Wrist plates. Gauntlets is what I was thinking.
Oh my god, I love it. How much is it?
What is that? Underneath it maybe?
I love that.
No. So they do a puzzle.
$22.99.
The $22.99 for.
Look, they've got a magnet. I love them.
So from the Book of Boba, you've got Boba Fett as well. Got.
I'm not seeing any Obi-Wan.
Yeah. Again, you've got Star Wars.
It's a Chewie backpack.
How much do you reckon? I'm going to go $60.
$69.99.
So $70 basically, and tax for a Chewie bag. Pretty cool, but.
It's cool.
I reckon.
But I'm very sweaty.
Yeah. You got some Baby Yoda bags. Which are $45 for a Baby Yoda bag.
It's like a wristlet, isn't it?
Yeah. They do lightsabers here as well. The only thing I don't like about it is you've got the Minnie Mouse ears on a lightsaber. But the lightsabers here are... Doesn't say a price.
Oh, that. No.
$20. Is this a bag again, or is this?
No, that's the teddy. That's a Chewie teddy. So $29.99.
So basically, all the teddies are $30.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Grogu collection sets. $10. Something for Ella would be
$29.99. Cool. I was just thinking for Ella.
Darth Vader helmets.
Oh, it's a voice changing helmet.
$35.
That's not bad.
No. RT Star Wars bath sets, just like they had the Guardians of the Galaxy ones. I wouldn't mind one of these for my desk.
$19.99. Remote control BB-8.
That's $55. So the connection shop's got quite a lot in.
We just start heading towards my... Oh, it's like a play set.
Yeah, so that's a TIE fighter with So this is based off The Mandalorian.
1999.
Again, more Mandalorian stuff.
Luke and an X-Wing.
Yes. But this is something that I really like, which was $20. If this fitted Paul would definitely wear that. They've got quite a, they've got some Grogu ears as well.
That's cute. I love that.
Yeah.
So we are headed back to Caribbean Beach. I can't remember the last time you saw her.
Would have been eating food at Connection Camp.
Yeah, so Luke said that he did some vlogging in.
Soon we'll be flying past Disney's Boardwalk Inn and Disney's Boardwalk Villas. This charming lakeside resort offers magical lounges, enchanting restaurants, and live entertainment on the boardwalk every evening.
Great.
Oh, and the Skyliner stopped as well. Fantastic. Yeah, so Luke said that he vlogged what we had for food.
The pizza's very sweet in America. The tomato sauce is very, very sweet.
They put more sugar in than you're used to.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we're gonna head back to the resort, have a wander around. Luke and I went to guest relations just to inquire about the DAS pass because of his ADHD, and they've given us one. Because Dad wasn't with us though, it's locked us out of the Disney Experience app. So she explained how to do it, but we might have to stop by guest relations again at some point to try and sort it. But yeah, very surprised by that. Didn't think we would, but hey ho. Luke and I will probably come back to Epcot later, dependent on the storms, because if my feet get wet again, I will cry.
Yeah.
powerful goddess Freya of Arnon would marry the great god Odd, who dwelled in Asgard. Freya journeyed to the realm of Aesir, where she presided over her own great hall called Gunga, which was equally as magnificent as Odin's Valhalla. The beautiful goddess was welcomed and adored by all of the Aesir gods. Yet she often longed for her husband Odd, who was off traveling the nine worlds. And so, Freya cleverly disguised herself as a majestic hawk and searched for her beloved husband. As she flew over the worlds, she wept sparkling tears. And when these tears struck the ground of Midgard, they transformed into precious droplets of gold.
Creepy as hell.
I think that's
a good idea. So.